morning. Welcome to the Deliverance Time broadcast. This ministry comes to you each week with the compliments of the members and friends of Eccles Assembly of God. You'll find us at lots 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, on the east bank of the Marara. We know the music which we have selected today will inspire you, and you will be challenged by the message. Stay tuned. Father and our God, we thank you for the privilege and the joy of being in your presence. In your presence, we can experience joy, healing, and deliverance as we yield ourselves to you. We pray that through this broadcast, you will reveal your glory and demonstrate your power. Bless the songs and the ministry of your word. Touch each listener in all the ways they need to receive your touch today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Lord,
God of the heavens, lift you up. King of all the earth, lift you up. Lord of the righteousness, give you glory in this place. We lift you up. Healer of nations, lift you up. God forevermore, lift you up. Oh, sovereign majesty, give you glory in this place. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power. Yours, O God, are the kingdoms of the earth. Worthy of honor, worthy alone of praise. Give you glory in this place. Give you glory in this place. We give you glory.
Lift up your name tonight, Jesus. Yes.
We lift you up.
Lift you up.
God of the heavens, lift you up.
We lift you up.
King of all the earth, we lift you up.
My joy to welcome you once more to this week's edition of the Deliverance Time broadcast, sponsored by the members and friends of Eccles Assembly of God. Eccles Assembly is located at Lots 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, right here on the east bank of Demerara. We'll meet at 8:15 this morning for Sunday school. And again, please be reminded that Sunday school is not just for children. We have a class for all ages. Our fellowship service begins at 9:30 this morning, in-house and online. So just in case you are unable to join us physically, you can connect with us on our Facebook page. That's the Eccles Assembly of God Facebook page for our fellowship service this morning, beginning at 9:30. Tuesday, Lord willing, at 10 in the morning, we'll have our Deliverance Miracle Service. Then on Wednesday at 6:30 in the evening, we have our Bible study, in-house and online. Remember to write and share with us the specific blessings you have been receiving through this broadcast and our online ministry. You may write to Deliverance Time, Cave of Eccles Assembly, 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, East Bank, Demerara. Or you may email us at Eccles AG, all one word, all lowercase, echoesag@gmail.com. Also, we have WhatsApp numbers on which you can contact us. And those numbers are 613-2024, 613-2024, and 624-8858, 624-8858. Call us as well on numbers 233-2124 and 233-2982, should you need any further spiritual help. Those numbers again are 233-2124 and 233-2982. Stay tuned and be blessed.
How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that He should give His only Son and make a wretch His treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turns His face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Ashamed, I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held Him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished.
Continue our meditation on the prophecy of Isaiah as recorded in chapter 53 of his book. That is Isaiah chapter 53. Actually, Isaiah's prophetic discourse on the suffering and exaltation of Jesus Christ began in chapter 52, beginning with verse 13. Here is what it says. See, my servant will act wisely. He will be raised and lifted up and highly exalted. Just as there were many who were appalled at him, his appearance was so disfigured beyond that of any man, and his form marred beyond human likeness, so will he sprinkle many nations, and kings will shut their mouths because of him. For what they were not told, they will see, and what they have not heard, they will understand. The prophet Isaiah is speaking about Jesus, the Christ, the Anointed One, the Messiah, the Son of God, who became the Son of Man, so that the sons and daughters of men can become sons and daughters of God. Notice, my friend, that Isaiah in verse 13 refers to the promised Messiah as servant. There are many servant passages in the book of Isaiah. Sometimes the term is used in reference to Israel, God's covenanted people. But in this particular verse, the term servant is a reference to Jesus, the promised Messiah, Redeemer, and Savior of all mankind. Now, I want you to observe with me a number of things about this servant that Isaiah is here speaking about. The Word of God says, first of all, he will act wisely or prudently. He shall deal prudently. He shall manage the affairs of his kingdom with admirable wisdom. His kingdom shall prosper. In his earlier prophecies, Isaiah stated in chapter 9, verse 7, here is what he says, of the increase of his government, speaking about the government of Jesus Christ, and peace, there will be no end. In this same chapter, verse 6, Isaiah declared prophetically, for unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. My dear friend, on the broadcast this morning, we are attempting to highlight the excellence of Jesus, the Son of God, who over 2,000 years ago laid down his life to redeem lost mankind. The Bible says that God made him, referring to Jesus, who had no sin, to be sin for us. In other words, our sins were laid on him, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. Going back to our text in chapter 52 of Isaiah, verse 13, the prophet Isaiah predicted, speaking of Jesus as God's supreme and ultimate servant, that he will act wisely. That means, like I said a while ago, he shall manage the affairs of his kingdom with admirable wisdom. Oh, how we need that kind of wisdom, which only God can give, to manage our lives, our homes and family. We need God's wisdom to manage our communities and our nation. The leaders of our world today need to humble themselves before Almighty God and seek his face for that divine wisdom to rule and to manage in a manner that is consistent with God's plans and expectations for the peoples of the earth. Whether in the home or as individuals, at the community level, the nation, or the world, my friend, the wisdom that we need is ours for the asking. Here is what James said to the first century Christians that were going through a time of persecution and dislocation. In James chapter 1 and verse 5, we read, if any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to him. There is widespread confusion in our society today, in Guyana and around the world. It would seem as though the more educated we become, the less competent we are to deal effectively with societal issues. We have more academic degrees now than at any other time in history. Yet we continue to face unprecedented challenges in the moral, ethical, and social arenas. We seem to be running out of options, or is it not that we have already run out of options to live a quiet and peaceable life? A life of godliness, decency, and genuine and lasting fulfillment. George Carlin, the mouthy comedian of the 80s, wrote after the 9/11 disaster, and I can assure you that there is nothing comical about his assertions. Here is what he says. We have more degrees, but less sense. More knowledge, but less judgment. More experts, yet more problems. More medicine, but less wellness. We have multiplied our possessions, but reduced our values. Taller buildings, but shorter tempers. We've learned how to make a living, but not a life. We've added years to life, but not life to years. As I mentioned earlier, there is absolutely nothing comical about these assertions of the late George Carlin. My friend, there are some issues of life that require the wisdom of God to deal with. Not a master's degree, not a PhD, the wisdom of God. Speaking of God's wisdom, the Bible declares in James chapter 3 and verse 13, "Who is wise and understanding among you? Let him show it by his good life, by deeds done in humility that comes from wisdom." Verse 14, "But if you harbor bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not boast about it or deny the truth. Such wisdom does not come from heaven, but is earthly, unspiritual, of the devil. For where you have envy and selfish ambition, there you find disorder and every evil practice. But a wisdom that comes from heaven," says James, "is first of all pure, then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere. Peacemakers," he says, "who sow in peace, raise a harvest of righteousness." And I pray, Lord, give us this kind of peace as individuals and as a nation. Speaking of Jesus, Isaiah said in our text, "He will act wisely." Let us pray. Eternal God and Father, we look to you at this time, conscious of our need of you. You are the all-wise God, the one on whom we can depend. We trust your unerring guidance and wisdom this morning. You do all things well. Today, we look to you, especially on behalf of our nation. We ask that you'll move sovereignly throughout the length and breadth of our beloved country. Give us all in our various spheres of influence that wisdom to speak and act wisely for your glory and for the good of our nation. We pray for listeners facing all sorts of challenges this morning. Help them to humble themselves and to call on you today. Remember those who do not know you in a personal way. Reveal yourself to them, speak to them, and may they yield themselves to you. Touch the sick, the needy, and the discouraged. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Friends, it was certainly a joy having you with us on the broadcast this morning. And we do look forward to having you next week by the grace of God when we will continue this message based on Isaiah chapter 53. Until the Lord richly bless you, everyone. Maker,
Jesus.